Welcome and good morning, dear students. In this session, we are going to see financial statements and introduction, part 1. You will learn here the meaning and the objectives of preparing financial statements and the purpose and preparation of trading account. Let's see the meaning of financial statements. Financial statements are the statements that are prepared at the end of the accounting period, which is generally 1 year. What are the components of financial statements? The first component is trading and profit and loss account, which is also called as income statement. And the second component is the balance sheet, which is also called the position statement. When a student has studied for a year and written the examination, he or she wants to know the result of that examination for that year. Similarly, every business enterprise wants to know the result of activities of the particular period, which is generally 1 year, and also the financial position on a particular date. Result in the sense whether they have made profit or loss, and financial position in the sense what are their assets and liabilities on a particular date. For this, it prepares various statements which are called the financial statements. What are the objectives of preparing these financial statements? The first and foremost objective is ascertaining the results of the business operations, then ascertaining the financial position of the business and the source of information, that is from where we have collected it. It helps in the managerial decision making. In the managerial decision making, various decisions the management has to make regarding the investment decisions, the dividend decisions and various other decisions, making of budget, etc. And then it is an index of solvency of the concern. Solvency in the sense whether the business is able to pay off its liabilities. What are the importance of financial statements? As we have seen earlier, it facilitates decision making. This is one of the most important thing in case of financial statements, because the management has to decide how much they have to invest in fixed asset, how much they have to invest in current asset, what will be the selling price, what will be the budget, etc. And also it shows the operational performance of the business. Operational performance means the operational efficiency, that is whether they have controlled the cost of goods sold, operating cost, non-operating cost, how in future they have to deal with the cost, etc. The preparation of trading account and profit and loss account requires the knowledge of some important items like revenue expenditure, revenue receipts, capital expenditure and capital receipts. Revenue items are recorded in the trading and profit and loss account, and capital items are recorded in the balance sheet. What is the capital expenditure? Capital expenditure refers to the expenditure incurred for acquiring fixed assets or assets which increase the earning capacity of the business, or the benefits of the capital expenditure to the firm extend to a number of years. And if you see the examples of capital expenditure, the first one, expenditure incurred for acquiring fixed assets like land, furniture, etc. Any fixed asset you buy, that becomes a capital expenditure. The second one, expenditure incurred for acquiring intangible assets like patent, trademark, etc. Like if you buy somebody else's technology, then you have to pay a lot of money to use that technology. For example, royalty, patent, trademarks, all these things. So the expenditure incurred on buying a patent or a technology, that expenditure also comes under capital expenditure. And also expenditure incurred for buying a software. Software, if you buy, it will be used for a number of years. So obviously it comes under capital expenditure. Also, if you increase the earning capacity of an asset, for example, if you got a cinema hall and if you are increasing the seating arrangements from 50 seats to 500 seats, then the benefits is likely to accrue for a longer period of time. So that kind of expenditure which is incurred for increasing the seating capacity or the earning capacity of a fixed asset falls under capital expenditure. Now let's see what is revenue expenditure. Revenue expenditure is an expenditure incurred in the course of normal business transactions of a concern, and its benefits are availed of during the same accounting year. This is the most important point. The benefits will be used within that particular accounting year. And if you see the examples of revenue expenditure, they are all day-to-day expenses like salaries, carriage, which means transportation expenses, postage, rent, etc. Examples of revenue expenditure, if you see, they are all day-to-day expenses. That is salaries, carriages, which means transportation expenses, postage, rent, etc. There is one more revenue expenditure which is called as deferred revenue expenditure. These are the expenses incurred during one accounting year, but the benefits from the same are available wholly or in part in future periods also. These expenditures are otherwise a revenue nature only. If you see the examples of deferred revenue expenditures, a very good example is advertisement expenditure. Like we spend crores of money in advertisement in one particular year, but the benefits of that advertisement will accrue for a number of years. So only a part of that expenditure will be shown as an expense in that particular year, and the expenses will be written off over a period of time till the time the benefits accrue for the advertisement expenditure. Same way, research and development expenditure, we spend a lot of amount on research and development, the benefits is likely to accrue for a longer period of time. So these kind of expenditures are termed as deferred revenue expenditure. Now we have studied capital expenditure and revenue expenditure. Let's try to differentiate between the same. If you see the purpose, in case of capital expenditure, it is incurred for acquiring fixed assets, but revenue expenditure is incurred for the maintenance of the fixed assets. For example, if you increase the seating capacity of a cinema hall, that is a capital expenditure. After that, if you spend some amount on repair and maintenance or for whitewashing that cinema hall, then it becomes a revenue expenditure. If you see the earning capacity, capital expenditure increases the earning capacity of the business, whereas revenue expenditure helps in maintaining the earning capacity of the business intact. Next one is periodicity of the benefit. Capital expenditure benefits are spread over a number of years, whereas revenue expenditure benefits are meant only for one accounting year. Next is placement in financial statements. Capital expenditure is an item of balance sheet and is shown as an item of asset in the balance sheet, whereas revenue expenditure is an item of trading and profit and loss account and is shown on the debit side of either of the two. If you see the occurrence of the expenditure, capital expenditure is non-recurring in nature, whereas revenue expenditure is usually recurring in nature. Now let's see about capital receipts. Capital receipts are receipts which do not arise out of normal course of business. For example, proceeds from the sale of fixed assets. Such receipts are not treated as income of the enterprise. If you see the proceeds from sale of fixed assets, we do not sell our assets again and again. Once in a while, when they need replacement or they have become obsolete, only then we sell such assets and some money is received. That kind of money which we receive once in a while, that receipt is called as capital receipt. So what are revenue receipts? Revenue receipts are receipts which arise during the normal course of the business. They are the items of income of the business entity. You see the examples of revenue receipts. Sale of goods. Whatever amount you collect by selling your goods, that is the best example of revenue receipt. And then any other income. For example, if you have rented your business office to any one of the person and he is giving you rent. That rent from the tenants is also a revenue receipt. Same way, if you have some extra money which you have invested in the shares and debentures of other companies, the dividends you receive from the shares and the interest you receive from the debentures, they all become the examples of revenue receipts. Now let's differentiate between capital receipt and revenue receipt. If you see the source, the receipts that do not arise during the normal course of the business, they are called as capital receipts, whereas receipts that arise during the normal course of the business is called as revenue receipt. And regarding the nature, capital receipts are the capital nature and hence are not treated as items of income of the business, whereas revenue receipts are of revenue nature and hence are treated as items of income of the business. Regarding the occurrence, capital receipts are non-recurring in nature, whereas revenue receipts are recurring in nature. Now let's see about trading account, which is also known as income statement. What is a trading account? A business firm either purchases goods from others or manufactures and sells them to earn profit. These are known as trading activities. A statement is prepared to know the results in terms of profit or loss of these activities. This statement is called as trading account. Trading account is prepared to ascertain the results of the trading activities of the business enterprise. It shows whether by selling the goods you have earned a profit or incurred a loss. This calls for a very important concept called cost of goods sold, which is also known as cost of sales. Cost of goods sold is the amount spent on the cost of material used in manufacturing the goods along with the direct labor cost used for producing the same. For example, cost of raw materials, wages, transportation expenses, which are also called as carriage, for bringing in goods or materials, and fuel, power, etc., they all constitute cost of goods sold or cost of sales. What is a gross profit? Cost of goods sold is subtracted from the net sales of the business of that accounting year. If you subtract cost of goods sold from net sales, the result you get is gross profit. Then what is the gross loss? It is just the opposite. When your cost of goods sold becomes more than your net sales, then you get a gross loss. What are the important items of trading account? Opening stock, net purchases, direct expenses such as wages, carriage inwards, etc., are debited to the trading account. Closing stock and net sales are the items that are credited to the trading account. What is net purchases? If you subtract purchases returns from gross purchases, you get net purchases. Same way, if you subtract sales returns from the total sales, you get your net sales. What is balancing of trading account? After posting all the items in the debit side and the credit side, trading account is balanced. If the credit side is more than the debit side, the result is gross profit. So the carried down balance will be shown in the debit side. If the debit side is more than the credit side, then the result is gross loss. So the balance carried down, that is the balancing figure, will be shown at the credit side. Credit balance shows the gross profit. For example, if you see this account, this is more like a ledger account with the debit side and the credit side. In the credit side, sales, net sales and closing stock are written, whereas in the debit side, opening stock, net purchases, carriage inwards and wages are written. If you see the credit side, the total amount is 1,94,000. Whereas the debit amount is only 53,000. Since the credit side is more than the debit side, we have got gross profit which is placed in the debit side. Now you can see a debit balance example. In this case, if you see the debit side, the total is 1,25,000. Whereas the credit side, the items amount to only 94,000. As a result, the debit side is more than the credit side, so the difference 31,000 has become a gross loss, which is placed in the credit side of trading account. Let's know more about cost of goods sold or cost of sales. Cost of goods sold is computed to know the profit earned from the trading activities of a business unit for a particular period. There are two formula to find out cost of goods sold. The first one is cost of goods sold is equal to net sales minus gross profit. The other formula is cost of sales is equal to opening stock plus net purchases plus direct expenses minus closing stock. Gross profit is equal to net sales minus cost of goods sold. Gross loss is equal to cost of goods sold minus net sales. Let's see a question. Calculate the cost of goods sold from the following information. Closing stock is given, purchases is given, carriage on purchases and wages is given. How to find the cost of goods sold? See the formula. Opening stock plus purchases plus direct expenses minus closing stock. Opening stock is 10,000 plus purchases 80,000 plus we have got two direct expenses. Both of them are added and they become 8,600. From these three items, we subtract our closing stock, which is 8,000. As a result, we get 90,600 as our cost of goods sold. Next is calculate cost of goods sold and gross profit from the following. The given items are sales, sales returns, opening stock, purchases, direct expenses and closing stock. How to calculate net sales? You subtract sales returns from sales, you get your net sales. From that, you subtract your cost of goods sold. That gives you 26,600. That is your gross profit. Next very important item of trading account is wages. Workers who are engaged in the process of loading, unloading and production of goods are paid wages. They are called as productive wages, direct wages or manufacturing wages. Sometimes the question, you will see the items wages and salaries or salaries and wages. Generally, wages are associated with factory and salaries are associated with office. In case of trading account, we take only those items that are related to the factory. As a result, in these two items, the student should check what is the first word of the given item. If the first word is wages, then it goes to the debit side of trading account. If the first word is salaries, then it goes to the debit side of profit and loss account. Next is carriage or freight. Transportation expenses incurred to bring goods from the place of seller to the place of the buyer is called as carriage or freight. Manufacturing expenses. Expenses incurred for production and for maintaining the factory, for example, gas, fuel, coal, electricity, water, factory rent, etc. are called as manufacturing expenses. Import duty. For importing goods, tax is paid to the government. It is a customs duty. This is a direct expense which is debited to trading account. Next is dock charges. Charges levied on ship and cargo while leaving or entering the dock is called dock charges. This is also a direct expense and debited to trading account. Royalty paid, amount paid to the owner of the mine, oil well or a patent holder for using this right by the user. This is also a direct expense. So again, it is debited to trading account. Let's see a question. From the following information for the year ending 31st March 2014, furnished by Mr. Vikram, a trader, calculate the cost of goods sold and also calculate gross profit or gross loss of the business. The given information, sales, purchases, octroi, carriage on purchases, purchases returns, opening stock and closing stock. You would like to know what is an octroi. The local taxes are imposed by the municipal corporation when goods enter the city. That amount is called as octroi. So, how to solve this question? First, find out the cost of goods sold using the given formula. Opening stock plus net purchases plus carriage on purchases plus octroi minus closing stock will give you the cost of goods sold, which is 78,900. How to find gross profit? Your net sales is 1,20,000. From that, you subtract your cost of goods sold 78,900, which results in a gross profit of 41,100. So, what is the need of making this trading account? To get the knowledge of gross profit and to get the knowledge of all the direct expenses. And very important, precaution against future losses. How do we prevent ourselves from future losses? By seeing the cost. If the cost has increased so much, we should take necessary steps to control the cost so that we get more gross profit. This is again the format of a complete trading account. If you see in the credit side, it is sales minus sales returns, that is the net sales, then the closing stock is given. And in the debit side, you can see the opening stock, net purchases, which is purchases minus purchases returns. And all the direct expenses are debited here. For example, carriage inwards, freight, wages, fuel and power, excise duty, factory rent, lighting, factory rent, factory insurance, works manager's salary, etc. So, depending upon the debit or credit balance, you will get the gross profit or gross loss. What are the important items of trading account we have seen till now? Stock, purchases, sales, direct expenses, gross profit or gross loss. Stock refers to the goods lying unsold on a particular date. It can be an opening stock or it can be closing stock. What is opening stock? Opening stock refers to the value of goods lying unsold at the beginning of the accounting year. And this is shown on the debit side of the trading account. But if you are starting your business fresh, then definitely you will not be having any opening stock. What is closing stock? It is the value of goods lying unsold at the end of the accounting year. It is valued at the cost price or the market price, whichever is less. Whichever price is less, it has to be valued on that price only. It is shown on the credit side of the trading account. Purchases, it takes into account both cash purchases as well as credit purchases, and it is shown on the debit side of trading account. And we have already seen what is net purchases. If you subtract purchases returns from the purchases, you get your net purchases. These are always shown as net purchases. The amount of purchases returned is always deducted from the total amount of purchases to figure out the net purchases. You can see how it is shown in the trading account on the debit side. Purchases, cash purchase and credit purchase, both of them are added. From that, the returns is subtracted and 70,000, the net purchases shown in the outer column of the trading account. Goods received on consignment basis are never treated as purchases. Similarly, goods received on sale or return basis are never treated as purchases. They should always be subtracted if they are included in the total purchases. Sales refers to the total revenue from the sale of goods of the business enterprise for which the trading account is being prepared. Here also we add both cash sales and credit sales to get the net sales, and it is recorded on the credit side of trading account. Sales are shown at their net value, that is, sales returns or returns inward is deducted from the total sales, and cash sales plus credit sales minus sales returns constitute the net sales. You can see how it is shown or depicted in the trading account credit side. Cash sales is shown, with that the credit sales is added. From both the things, the sales returns is subtracted, which gives you the net sales, which is 1,01,000. good scent on sale or approval are not part of the sales until the approval is received. Direct expenses. Direct expenses are the expenses that can be attributed directly to the purchase of goods or goods manufactured, and they are always recorded on the debit side of trading account. These are shown at the amount as shown in the trial balance. For example, wages are recorded on the debit side of trading account at the amount shown in the trial balance. Important items of direct expenses. Wages. Only wages related to production are shown in the trading account. If amount under this head includes wages paid for construction of building or manufacturing of furniture for office, then it will be subtracted from the amount of wages. Same way, carriage, carriage inwards, freight, etc. This is the amount paid for transporting the goods purchased for sale or raw materials purchased for manufacturing. Other important items of direct expenses are customs duty, import duty, packing materials, gas expenses, electricity expenses, water, fuel, oil, gas expenses, heating and lighting expenses, factory rent and factory insurance expenses, and many more such items. All those who are connected with the factory or manufacturing or production are shown as direct expenses. So in the trading account, if the credit side exceeds the total of debit side, the excess amount is termed as gross profit and is shown on the debit side of trading account. Same way, if the debit side exceeds the credit side, then you get a gross loss, which is shown on the credit side of trading account. So till now we have learnt the meaning and objectives of preparing financial statements, purpose and preparation of trading account. I hope you must have understood all those that has been taught in this session properly. Thank you.
घर बैठे पाएं राष्ट्रीय मुक्त विद्यालय शिक्षा संस्थान यानी NIOS में एडमिशन, वो भी एकदम आसान तरीके से, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को होगी समय और धन दोनों की बचत। NIOS से शिक्षा कभी भी कहीं भी। शिक्षार्थियों, क्या आप जानते हैं NIOS में एडमिशन लेने का सरल और सुगम तरीका, जिससे शिक्षार्थियों को ऑनलाइन प्रवेश लेने में सहूलियत मिलती है। NIOS में प्रवेश की प्रक्रिया पूर्णतया ऑनलाइन है। शिक्षार्थी घर बैठे इंटरनेट द्वारा प्रवेश के लिए सबसे पहले NIOS की वेबसाइट www.nios.ac.in पर लॉगिन करें। अपना ईमेल आईडी और पासवर्ड डालकर अपना पंजीकरण करें। पंजीकरण के बाद लॉगिन करने पर ऑनलाइन प्रवेश हेतु आवेदन पत्र खुलेगा। आवेदन पत्र को निर्देशानुसार भरें और प्रिंट आउट लें। इस प्रिंट आउट पर अपनी फोटो संलग्न करें। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश के लिए शुल्क हेतु भुगतान के तरीके हैं। क्रेडिट कार्ड के द्वारा, डेबिट कार्ड के द्वारा, राष्ट्रकृत बैंक के ड्राफ्ट के माध्यम से, जो कि सचिव NIOS नई दिल्ली या नोएडा के पक्ष में देय हो। भरे हुए आवेदन पत्र के साथ साथ डिमांड ड्राफ्ट और संलग्न किए जाने वाले दस्तावेज हैं जन्म रजिस्ट्रार के जिला कार्यालय से जारी जन्म प्रमाण पत्र की सत्यापित प्रति, जिसमें जन्म तिथि अंकित हो, पिछले विद्यालय से प्राप्त विद्यालय छोड़ने का प्रमाण पत्र जिसमें आवेदक की जन्म तिथि लिखी हो, प्रवेश फॉर्म का प्रिंट आउट NIOS के संबद्ध क्षेत्र केंद्रों पर 10 दिनों में पहुंच जाना चाहिए, अन्यथा उचित दस्तावेज ना लगे होने पर आवेदन फॉर्म रद्द किया जा सकता है। प्रवेश प्रक्रिया की पुष्टि होने के बाद शिक्षार्थियों को परिचय पत्र व अध्ययन सामग्री डाक द्वारा तुरंत पहुंचाई जाती है। ऑनलाइन प्रवेश एक बहुत ही सुगम और सुविधाजनक प्रवेश प्रणाली है। ऑनलाइन ऑन टाइम फॉर सेफ एंड सिक्योर एडमिशन।